Okay, next, we're going to look into vacation of office. When we talk about vacation, there's two things we're going to discuss, which is removal, and the other one is resignation of auditors. Okay, members of company may remove an auditor from office at any time by ordinary resolution at the general meeting, and secondly, in accordance with Section 277. So, this matter of removal is actually provided under Section 276, subsection 1. Okay, so we can go on further into looking at Section 277, which stipulates the procedures. So there'll be a special notice, okay, and then the auditors should also special notice of resolution. Now, when we talk about special notice, we talk about 28 days of notice. So basically, 28 days. Ordinary resolution 14 days, special resolution 21 days, and special notice is actually 28 days, but ordinary resolution. Okay. So Section 277 talks about special notice for resolution to remove, and upon receiving the special notice, sorry. Basically, a copy of the notice will be given to the auditor. An auditor may make representation in writing not exceeding some reasonable length within 7 days from receipt of the special notice. And then basically a copy of representation will be circulated. Okay. And upon request of auditor as well, company will send a copy of representation to every member to whom the notice is also sent. Okay, when the representation is not sent, the auditor may have a right to be heard orally. Now, a representation normally will be read out at the meeting. Okay, so what does representation consist of? Reasons of them not to be removed as auditor. Okay. So application a copy of representation need not be circulated, and representation need not be read at the meeting if the application either of the company or any person claiming to be aggrieved, the court satisfied that the auditor is used the court is satisfied that auditor is using Section 277 subsection 6 to secure publicity. Or the matter if defamatory, because sometimes during the auditing, the auditor might find certain information regarding the company. So those information might be defamatory, or it might be of public interest. Sometimes if they find it that those are the two things that is actually will jeopardize or will create havoc, so they can actually apply to the court not to actually to read out the representation, okay, and those grounds given to the court must be reasonable. Now, in the event a resolution to remove an auditor is passed under Section 276, okay, which is the ordinary resolution, the company shall give a notice to the of the fact to the registrar within 14 days. Okay, let me just double check again. Is it 14 days? 276. 276. Okay, lodgement. Okay, yes. 14 days. Okay, the other method of vacation of office is resignation of auditors. This is provided under Section 281, where the auditor may actually give notice in writing that he will be resign. So basically, those notices actually putting the auditor's term to an end. Normally within after 21 days from the notice given. Okay, so basically, an auditor who resign, they will give a copy to the registrar. Company will give a copy of the notice to the registrar within 7 days of receiving the notice of registration. Sorry, resignation. Okay, for public company, auditor may give notice of resignation together with signed requisition on calling of directors to convene a general meeting only for the purpose of receiving and considering explanation of the circumstances connected with his resignation. Okay, and then in fact, auditor may also request company to circulate statement in writing not exceeding a reasonable length connected with the auditor's resignation before the meeting. So basically, normally those representation would actually explain reasons of why he resigned. Okay, and then under section 283, subsection 4, company shall state the fact that a statement has been made in any notice of the meeting given to the company and a copy of the statement to every and also send a copy of the statement to every member to whom notice of the meeting or his is or has been sent. So basically, notice also must be given as well as a copy of those statement. Okay, and then pursuant to section 283 subsection 5. Okay, so director shall hold general meeting required within 28 days from the day of receiving notice of requisition. So requisition is actually more on the discussing about the resignation of the auditor. Okay, now section 283 subsection 7 allows a copy of the statement not to be sent or read out at the meeting if on the application either the company or the person agree that the court is also satisfied. Same reason, matter of publicity or probably involve defamatory statement. You have learned defamatory statement before and you know what does it mean. Yeah, okay, next one we are going to talk about rights of auditors. What are the rights of auditors? So basically, auditors' statutory rights are given under section 266. So a right to assess or at all reasonable times the accounting and other records. Of course, auditors need to have this access in order to check all those records. And then they may also require any officer to give information and explanation if they desires to obtain. And then as well as the other rights, these are the three big rights. To attend at any general meeting of the company, on the right to be heard on any part of the business thereof. Okay, I saw this. Okay, so these are the three big rights. Okay, and then next we're going to move on into duties. Same as directors, same as company secretaries, we have the statutory duties. Okay, these are provided under section 266 subsection 1. Auditor shall give shall report to the members on the financial statement, right? And normally those are laid during the AGM. And for private companies, that one AGM is for public company. For private companies, they can circulate all those documents. And then section 266 subsection 2 paragraph A requires the auditor to report and also to give a true and fair view of the matters and then of the company's affairs and make sure that all accounting are according to the accounting standard. So basically, for this statutory duties, okay, of the auditors, so these are all governed by section 266. So if you look at section 2662, okay, B, okay, he must also in his opinion state that the account is drawn up with the approved standard, give a true and fair view of those statements, and then quantify financial effect, and if it's a consolidated financial statement, they actually by right they must also give their fair views. And then under section 266 subsection 2 paragraph C, in the case of consolidated financial statement, the name of the subsidiary, if any, if it has not acted as an auditor. So basically, whatever within the company, he must actually explain. Okay, And then section 266 subsection 3 is for the duty of the director to form opinion on all those information obtained. And then basically he should actually inform whether there were proper accounting reports being kept, and then whether returns are adequate, and then whether procedures used by holding company or subsidiary arriving at all those accounts involving accounts are properly appropriate. And then section 260 subsection 6 requires auditor's report to be attached and endorsed on the financial statement. So basically, an auditor should be well versed in accounting and all financial statement, because if they actually don't report accurately, they can be liable for negligence. The case involving negligence of auditors is in the Kaparo Industries, public listed company, and Dickman and others. So in this case, Lord Oliver says that it is the auditor's function to ensure as far as possible that the financial information as to the company's affairs prepared by the directors accurately reflects the company's position, in order first to protect the company from consequences of undetected error or possibly wrongdoing, and then secondly to provide shareholders with reliable intelligence information basically for the purpose of enabling them to scrutinize the conduct of the company's affairs and exercise their collective powers to reward or control or remove those whom they find it the conduct has been confided. So basically this case is regarding the auditor's negligence if they fail to carry out their duties. Okay, that one is as far as statutory duties is concerned. There are other duties, such as duty to carry out audit. Okay, duty to carry out audit. He actually requires to devise procedures to assist in detection of errors or fraud. Sorry for the small handwriting. Like I said, it was not prepared by me. He tried to compress everything in one slide. Okay, and there's also duties to report to members, on the account during the AGM. Later, I believe during the next semester, you're going to attend AGM, and then you're going to see that how those matters are being laid during the AGM. And then he is required to state in his report whether, in his opinion, the accounts were properly drawn and are in accordance with the Act, so as to give a true and fair view of the financial position. And then again, I have mentioned just now, auditors must be impartial. So auditors has a duty to be independent. Okay, independency ensures that shareholders receive an unbiased opinion. Okay. And then lastly, there's a duty to use reasonable care and skill. Okay, so during when they carry out their duty as an auditor shall actually act with reasonable care and skill. The same thing like the directors. Okay, now what are the liabilities of an auditor? Okay, they have liability in contract. They have liability in negligence. Professional owed a duty of care. Again, there's also case of Kaparo. Now, there's another case here being given to you. Re Kingston Cotton Mill. Okay, and then Cutler and Crane, whereby it is the duty of the auditor. They only owe to their client and not to an outsider. Okay, and then Aronson and Carson Beckman. Court held an expert who valued share, knowing that valuation was to be used by buyers and seller in calculating the price of the shares, was liable to them both if he or she made the valuation negligently. So this is also on the auditor. Okay, and then Kaparo and Industries and Dickman, This is actually the most important case